pace, maybe give a little like on the video that you see right in front of you. And well, you know, things have just gotten very interesting. We have a national championship game, and we know who those two teams will be. The number one team in the country, the Alabama Crimson Tide, who pretty much dominated Notre Dame 31-14, pretty much as we expected. Devontae Smith, it looks like he will win the Heisman instead. And I'm going with that as the guy who's going to win the Heisman, you know, instead of Kyle Trask. Speaking of the Gators, they got absolutely blown out yesterday, you know, or rather 2 days ago by Oklahoma. And how about those Cincinnati Bearcats and the Georgia Bulldogs? Played a damn good game. Both teams were dominant, you know, in one half. And I mean, Cincinnati was dominant in the first half, Georgia dominant in the second half. You know, very damn good game in the Peach Bowl out in Atlanta. And, you know, Cincinnati, you guys deserve all the credit in the world. I don't want to hear those arguments anymore about, oh, well, this team wasn't motivated. Both teams were missing players. Both teams missing players due to opt-outs or injuries or whatever, or COVID or whatever. Both teams were missing players. Get that narrative out of your head right now. It was a damn good game. And opt-outs are just going to continue. So, you know, I mean, we're going to need to expand the playoff anyway because, I mean, Oklahoma made a very damn good case, you know, the other night to say, hey, let's expand this playoff. Let's, you know, can we get in on some of that playoff pie, you know? Come on. And I know A&M fans are still kind of salty. I'm kind of, you know, at this point, you know, as a Texas fan, I'm like, okay, shut up. You guys are Texas A&M fans. You're the little kids. Sit down. Be humble. And know your place. You know, I get it. Texas is kind of booty cheeks this year. But, you know, as it has been for the last 10 years since we lost to Alabama in the national championship back in 2010. But A&M, know your place. You guys are usually third or fourth place in the SEC. You got lucky this year. Got not close, but calm down. You have a bowl game tomorrow. And speaking of those two bowl games, the Fiesta and the Orange Bowls, I will be recapping those two games tomorrow. So we only have one undefeated team left. You know, that could be undefeated. There could be only one undefeated team left after January the 11th. Would be the Ohio State Buckeyes, who, with Justin Fields at quarterback, just absolutely went off tonight against the Clemson Tigers. We're talking absolutely disgusting. I thought this was going to be a blowout, but I didn't think it would be this way. You know, I mean, there was just the Ohio State defense was suffocating. Trevor Lawrence couldn't get anything going on this Ohio State defense. This defense is tough for the Buckeyes. You know, Trey Sermon was running all over. It wasn't 331 yards again, but hey, Olave was getting stuff done for, you know, the Buckeyes too. It was some deep, deep passes and the targeting call in this game as well that didn't really change the tide of the game because Ohio State was already up by two touchdowns. But there was, you know, Ohio State had this game under wraps from the moment it started. I mean, this is what she came here for. We thought that this would be Alabama Clemson part 5 or part 6 or whatever, you know, whatever type of whatever part we're on with this Alabama Clemson thing. But it didn't turn out that way for the Tigers this time. They got stomped, you know. Trevor Lawrence is going to probably leave, like Kyle Trask has done, and like Zach Wilson has done, and like Sam Ehlinger is going to do. You know, a lot of quarterbacks are going to be taken potentially in this year's NFL draft. And, you know, Lawrence, you know, he's got to feel, I don't know how bad to feel for Trevor. Like, this dude's probably going to get drafted by the Jags. Oh my God. You know, and an embarrassing loss like this. this. You know Dabo is pissed. You know he's pissed. Ryan Day is just like, he is feeling like the happiest guy in the world right now. And now he has to go up against, you know, the Sith Lord, the mothership of Alabama. And that Crimson Tide offense, you know, that defense. You know, Alabama's defense hasn't been the greatest this year, and I get that, but Notre Dame didn't have an answer for that defense. But Alabama can still get it done. So, you know, got to bring your A game like you did against Clemson if you want to beat Alabama, Ohio State. But yeah, you know, Devontae Smith, Najee Harris, and Mac Jones went off against Notre Dame, you know. It was just the rat poison. And what do we say now? You know, I'm sure the comments are going to come in and say, you know, people commenting on the Alabama-Notre Dame game. It's like, oh, well, Notre Dame, they didn't play anybody, so that's why they don't need to go to the playoffs anymore. No, they had the worthy resume to go to the playoffs. It doesn't matter if Clemson was missing Trevor Lawrence due to Corona Chan. Clemson has 5-star caliber players each and every week. So I don't want to hear that excuse anymore, you know. That excuse was stupid. A&M didn't have it. A&M didn't have the schedule. They didn't have the wins because the Florida win lost its value once LSU beat them. Cincinnati, nobody in the group of five could schedule Power 5 teams this year unless you were the Sun Belt. And even then, nobody thinks of the Sun Belt as a good conference, even though it is a good conference. And, you know, we know about Coastal Carolina already delivered us two of the best games of the season, you know, with the Cure Bowl a couple days ago and now. And, of course, that Mormons versus Mullets game, which is going to get a second, you know, game in that series because of home and homes type stuff. But, you know, Sun Belt, damn good this year. And, we, you know, I think there's a lot of questions that we have to come out from all this. You know, what in the world is going to happen, you know, as far as what the playoffs are going to look like? You know, now we've been at this 7 years. We have 5 years left to go on this contract with the CFP and, you know, the old BCS committee. You know, a bunch of powerful, rich dudes who probably don't know really too much about football, but they do at the same time. And, you know, we still have 5 years left of that. So, again, you know, posing that question of expansion, is it going to happen soon? Is it going to happen, you know, whenever? You know, blah, 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 blah. It'll happen. We're going to need 5 more years. And will a group of five team ever get into the 4-team structure? I don't know. The answer has looked like no, but it seems that the right cards are going to have to come into play. And speaking of Cincinnati, once again, you know, they're going to have to, if 2021, you know, goes well without a hitch, and we get everybody playing 12 games again in the FBS level, and we get the FCS back on track with them actually playing in the fall and stuff like that instead of the spring nonsense that they're doing, Cincinnati has a opportunity to prove themselves with the right schedule. Of course, there are other teams that could potentially have this as well. You never know. And I don't really delve into college football all season like that. So there's not really going to be a lot of off-season videos about, you know, college football on this channel. So, you know, if you're looking for that, sorry, I'm not going to deliver that to you. But, you know, again, I think that there isn't going to be a lot that has to be said. Do we penalize Notre Dame or something like that? And the answer to that is no. We're not going to penalize Notre Dame. There's no reason to penalize Notre Dame because they, you know, they had the stuff. They had the stuff there, you know. They had the best win in the season until tonight with Ohio State beating Clemson, which was beating this exact same Clemson team with the same amount of talent, you know, minus their quarterback and minus a couple other guys. Still beat them. Second question is, what about the group of five? Is there a group of five team worthy going to the playoff? The answer is maybe. The cards have to go into place, like I said before. We'll find it out, you know, in these next 5 years. But right now, it's looking like a no. The highest the group of five team has ever gotten is number 8. You know, as far as the final rankings go, which is the only rankings that matter, you know, final rankings, UCF back in 2018 was, what, 8th, and Cincinnati this year, 8th. And speaking of, you know, some of these conferences, what about the Pac-12, and Big 12, because they are the two conferences that usually miss the playoffs, along with the Big 10 too, ACC, SEC, only two conferences to get a team in every year of this playoff. The Pac-12 has missed, what, 5 years now? And the Big 12 only has Oklahoma right now. So that means somebody in this conference is going to have to step up in the Big 12. And as a fan of the team that y'all know needs to step up, it's going to be, you know, a bumpy ride for this conference if Oklahoma continues to win, you know, the Big 12 every year. And the Pac-12 is just chaotic as ever. I don't really know. We could be completely wrong here on this first day of 2021, to where it's like, oh well, this team, you know, with the Pac-12, they can't get it done. Then again, they can get it done. You know, never know. You never know. But yeah, so there we have it. That is, you know, some of these bowl games. My thoughts on some of these bowl games. You know, bowl games really aren't as important as they used to. Well, they never were important. They're just glorified exhibitions. But they were important to the players. They were important to these teams, these fans, these coaches, and, you know, all these alumni and stuff like that. You know, so the sanctity of bowl games doesn't mean anything. You know, we probably need to restructure everything. And speaking of, you know, restructuring, you know, we're definitely going to expand to 8 teams after this contract runs out, I think. You know, but you're here for the Alabama-Ohio State stuff, right? Well, I'll do a preview for that, and it won't be today. It will be later on next week, so you'll have to stick around for that. Come on down, subscribe, and get me up to 100, because I've been at this for 3 years, and, you know, it's been 3 years now, and I'm ready to hit that milestone. For the first time, I'm ready to hit one of my first YouTube milestones since I made 260 videos in 2020. And, you know, I think a lot and analyze a lot. I already said what I needed to say about 2020 yesterday. It's 2021, so we started out greatly with 2021. So if you stuck around to the end, that is great. If you didn't, you're going to have to. You got me. Come on and stick around to the end. But with that being said, everybody, I will see you probably tomorrow night, potentially. I don't know. It's looking like a maybe at this time to talk about the other two bowl games that are left, along with a couple others. But yeah, New Year's Day was a great day. And again, you know, just a damn good day for some football. A damn good day. Take care.